हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल फिजिक्स ट्रिक्स। सो लास्ट वीडियो में हमने देखा था जो फोटोन है वो लेट सपोज एनर्जी है वो फ्रॉम एनी सोर्स, राइट? एनर्जी फ्रॉम एनी सोर्स इज इंटीग्रल मल्टीपल ऑफ एनर्जी ऑफ वन फोटोन, राइट? सो वी कंक्लूड दैट एनर्जी ऑफ एनी इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन इज अ quantized energy, right? Quantized energy means what? We can count, right? So quantized means we can count. So energy from any electromagnetic radiation is equal to the integral multiple of energy of one photon. That is what we concluded from last lecture. Now we'll study about photon count from any light source, right? So in this class we'll study about photon count, right? Photon count from any source, emitted by any source, any light source, right? Now let us consider a bulb. This is a bulb. Now this bulb will emit energy in three dimensions, right? So this bulb will emit energy in a sphere, right? So now from the properties of photon, any light source emits a photon, and that photon travels with speed of light, right? So now what is the number count of this? So we know that from first class that energy from any source is equal to integral multiple of energy of one photon, isn't it? So if we divide this by time, we'll get this as a power. So power from any source is integral multiple of power of one photon, isn't it? So number of photons per unit time into energy of one photon. So from this we can say number of photons or photon count, photons, is equal to power of source. This light source has power P, supposed to be power of source divided by energy of one photon into time, isn't it? Now if they say find out the number of photons per second, so time is equal to 1 second, find out the number of photons emitted by this bulb in 1 hour, multiply this by 1 hour and convert that 1 hour into seconds. It is that simple. So number of photons you can calculate by using this formula, and this formula is very very important, right? And this E is nothing but what? E is the energy of one photon. So this you have to remember, E is equal to hc by lambda, and I told you to remember hc value, that is 12,400 electron volt angstrom, right? And lambda we have to take in angstrom. So P by E into T. Now one more thing which is very important here is power we can write in terms of intensity, right? Power is equal to intensity into area. Or what is intensity? Intensity is energy per unit area per unit time, right? So that is energy per unit time is power. So power by area. So power by area is equal to intensity. What is power? Intensity into area. So number of photons in terms of intensity we can write it as number of photons in terms of intensity. Power in terms of intensity is I into A divided by E into time, right? Into time. Or number of photons per second is I A divided by E, and this E is hc by lambda. So this is the second very important formula in terms of intensity, right? So this is the in terms of intensity. Now intensity in intensity for point source, intensity for, let us suppose, line source, intensity for plane source, what are the intensity, right? For first one, for point source, you have to remember this. For point source, intensity is inversely proportional to R square. Right, why R mean it is inversely proportional to R square? Because from point source it will emerge out in three dimension, it will be in sphere, and we know that intensity is power by area, area of surface area of sphere is 4 pi R square. Right, so from point source it will be sphere, and if we consider at distance R, it will be 4 pi R square, and intensity is equal to power by area. Power at this point is same, so that's why it is inversely proportional to R square. Okay, now second one is line source. Line source, for line source intensity is inversely proportional to R. Why? Because for line source we have to consider a cylinder, and we know that for cylinder, what is the surface area of cylinder? 2 pi r into h, whatever the height of the cylinder is. Right? So this is r. So intensity in this case is inversely proportional to r. And for plane source, we cannot consider any closed area. So for that, intensity is constant. So for planar source, it is constant. For point source, it is inversely proportional to r square. And for line source, it is inversely proportional to R. So these all points are very important. So photon count, in this photon count, number of photons in terms of power is P by E into time. Number of photons in terms of intensity is IA divided by E into time. E is nothing but what? Energy of one photon, that is equal to hc by lambda. Now we will study about photon flux. Okay, so we know that magnetic flux, we know that electric flux. What is this photon flux, right? So this photon flux is defined as number of photons emitted per second per unit area. So photon flux is defined as number of photons emitted from source, radiation source, per second per unit area. This is called as photon flux, right? So photon flux phi is equal to number of photons emitted per second. Number of photons emitted per second is n by t, isn't it? Divided by per second, t is equal to 1 second, right? Divided by area. So this is the photon flux. And number of photons per unit time is equal to, we can write n by t is equal to power of source divided by energy of the source. So power divided by energy divided by area, which is equal to, now power divided by energy. Energy is energy of one photon. So we can write here power divided by A into energy of one photon is hc by lambda, right? So from this we will get a result, P into lambda divided by A into h into c. Now power in terms of intensity we know, I into A, put in this. So photon flux, finally we can write I lambda divided by hc, isn't it? See here, this is I lambda divided by hc. So I is intensity, lambda is wavelength, h is Planck's constant, 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 34. This value is very important. See, 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So this is the photon flux. Now we'll talk about the radiation pressure. So this is photon flux, which is very important. That is number of photons emitted from source per second per unit area, that is the photon flux. Ab dekhenge hum radiation pressure kya hota hai. So radiation pressure bahut hi important topic hai as per the NEET and JEE concern, right? So ye radiation pressure jo hai wo kya hota hai. Let us consider we have a plane surface, right? This is the plane surface, And on this plane surface, light of intensity I is incident, right? Or incident, supposed to be. So light is incident over here, suppose. Now, what is radiation pressure? So pressure exerted by radiation, pressure exerted by the light radiation on this unit area, that is called as radiation pressure on this surface due to the light, right? So radiation pressure is pressure exerted by the radiation of a light on this unit surface area, that is what the radiation pressure is. Okay, so let us consider now this case. In this case, if we consider only one photon, right? So one photon, and we are considering first case over here, as this surface is perfectly reflecting surface. Second case we have, this surface is perfectly absorbing surface. And third case we have, this surface is neither perfectly reflecting nor perfectly absorbing. So first case we are considering, this surface is perfectly reflecting, right? So this surface is perfectly reflecting. So in this case we are considering R is equal to 1. So as this surface has both property absorption plus reflection, that is equal to 1, and ये जो है ये absorption reflection is plus transmission also there, that is the case of heat and all, वो देख लेंगे बाद में हम. तो यहाँ पर देखिए ये जो absorption plus the reflection है वही हम consider कर रहे हैं, बाकी कुछ consider नहीं कर रहे. तो that is equal to 1 होना चाहिए यहाँ पर. तो R is equal to 1 हो गया, तो A is equal to क्या हो जाएगा, 0 हो जाएगा यहाँ पर. तो हम सिर्फ एक photon की बात कर रहे हैं यहाँ पर. अगर ये एक photon है, उसका जो मोमेंटम होता है वो कितना होता है, वो होता है h by lambda. तो इस टाइम इसके ऊपर मोमेंटम जो होगा वो नीचे h by lambda होगा, तो वो रिफ्लेक्ट होके ऊपर जाएगा, और वो कितने से जाएगा, h by lambda से ही जाएगा, perfectly reflecting है, isn't it? तो इसका जो change in momentum होता है वो कितना होगा, change in momentum इसका होगा delta p is equal to final momentum minus the initial momentum. So final momentum h by lambda minus of downward direction negative, so minus of minus h by lambda is 2h by lambda, isn't it? Hope ये clear होगा, mechanics का part है, बहुत simple है ये, right? So downward direction हम consider कर रहे हैं यहाँ पर, downward direction negative. So h by lambda minus of minus h by lambda is plus, so 2h by lambda. So ये हो गया हमारा change in momentum. अब change in momentum तो मिल गया हमको force निकालना है, और force से pressure निकालना है. तो पहले force निकालते हैं. So force क्या होता है, force होता है change in momentum by change in time. तो हमको average force निकालना है. तो average force in 1 second supposed to be, because हमको नंबर ऑफ फोटॉन्स कितने इंसिडेंट हो रहे हैं एक सेकंड में, वो ही उससे ही रेडिएशन प्रेशर निकालना है. तो यहां पर जो हमारा एवरेज फोर्स होगा, एवरेज फोर्स यहां पर लिख रहा हूं मैं, एवरेज फोर्स विच इज इक्वल टू चेंज इन मोमेंटम इन 1 second में, जितना चेंज इन मोमेंटम होगा वही तो हमारा एवरेज फोर्स होगा. तो यहां पर चेंज इन मोमेंटम कितना है, देखिए 2h by lambda, तो यही हो गया हमारा f average. लेकिन ये एक फोटोन की वजह से है, तो नंबर ऑफ फोटॉन्स इन 1 second कितने हैं, वो है n by t. तो यहां पर f average जो होगा due to whole photons in 1 second, वो होगा नंबर ऑफ फोटॉन्स इन 1 second into 2h by lambda. लेकिन ये n by t की वैल्यू तो हमको पता है, क्या है वो, n by t is number of photons per unit time, power by e. So power divided by e and into 2h by lambda, which will, e is hc by lambda. So p divided by hc lambda into 2h by lambda, h lambda cancel. So from this we'll get 2p divided by c. Now in terms of intensity, it is 2ia by c. Okay, why? Because power is intensity into area. अब देखिए average force ये आ गया हमारा. अब हमको pressure निकालना, radiation pressure निकालना. तो pressure क्या हो जाएगा? Pressure हो जाएगा हमारा average force divided by area, which is what is average force? 2ia by c, 2ia by c into a, ये a cancel और हमारा जो radiation pressure है वो मिल जाएगा हमको 2i by c. ये है हमारा radiation pressure. तो ये perfectly reflecting surface के लिए है. अभी perfectly absorbing surface के लिए क्या होगा? A is equal to 1, right? In that case, ये जो photon होगा वो absorb हो जाएगा. That means h by lambda जो होगा upward direction में वो नहीं होगा. तो वो सिर्फ momentum change in momentum कहाँ पर आएगा? H by lambda. तो यहाँ पर delta p is equal to h by lambda आएगा. So अगर delta p h by lambda है, तो यहाँ पर average force कितना होगा? H by lambda होगा. और यहाँ पर average force कितना होगा? H by lambda into p by e. तो ये सिर्फ 2 cancel out हो जाएगा और a by c हो जाएगा. और यहाँ पर हमारा radiation pressure जो है वो हो जाएगा i by c for perfectly absorbing surface. और for neither perfectly reflecting and perfectly absorbing, we can calculate by using same method that I'll calculate now. Now third case, in this third case we are considering the surface, given surface, whatever surface is there, this surface is neither perfectly reflecting nor perfectly absorbing. So here we are considering neither reflecting nor absorbing, right? So this is what the case is, right? So in that case we know that a plus r is equal to 1, right? So from this we can write a is equal to 1 minus r, and for reflecting let us consider r is the reflecting. Okay, so now same, now we have to consider two cases. First, if photon is reflecting back, so here we have h by lambda reflecting, so here we have h by lambda, and for absorbing here we have h by lambda, and here there is no, as this photon is absorbed, there is no upward momentum, so change in momentum is h by lambda only. Here change in momentum is 2h by lambda. Here change in momentum is h by lambda. Right. अब हमको average force निकालना है. Average force जो होगा, वो क्या होगा? Average force होगा यहाँ पर. Average force होगा change in momentum in 1 second. वो कितना होगा? 2h by lambda. और यहाँ पर average force क्या होगा? H by lambda होगा. अब यहाँ पर number of photons per second जो reflect हो रहे हैं वो कितने होंगे? Number of photons per second power of source divided by energy of one photon into reflecting power, that is reflecting power is R. So we have to consider here number of photons per second is equal to how much? Power of the source divided by energy of one photon into reflecting power R. Likewise here N by T is equal to power divided by E in bracket 1 minus R, isn't it? तो ये हमको इससे मल्टीप्लाई करना होगा, तब हमको क्या मिलेगा? F average मिलेगा, right? So यहाँ से जो प्रेशर होगा हमारा in first case वो हो जाएगा f average power So F average is equal to due to total, right? Due to total now P by E into R into 2H by lambda. P by E into R into 2H by lambda. So which is equal to this P is nothing but I into A divided by E into 2H by lambda into R. So E is nothing but HC by lambda, H and that cancel. So we'll get 2IA divided by C into R. ये first case में हो जाएगा और ये second case में क्या होगा? Same, इसमें भी F average जो होगा वो होगा P by E 1 minus R H by lambda होगा यहाँ पर बस यहाँ पर H by lambda होगा और यहाँ पर हमको जो मिलेगा वो IA by C into 1 minus R के टर्म में मिलेगा और हमको जो टोटल निकालना है इन दोनों की एडिशन करनी पड़ेगी हमको और वो जो एडिशन है वो हो जाएगा F total is equal to C here 2IA by C into R and this one if we add this you will, we will get IA by C 1 plus R right so ये जो है ये F total हो गया अब हमारा radiation pressure due to this is so pressure is equal to मिल जाएगा directly radiation pressure P is equal to हम लिख सकते हैं ये area यहाँ पर आ जाएगा और ये I by C 1 plus R हो जाएगा और ये जो case है इस केस से हम बाकी दोनों केसेस कर सकते हैं अगर परफेक्टली रिफ्लेक्टिंग है तो R is equal to 1 हो जाएगा और उस केस में 2 I by C होता है रेडिएशन प्रेशर यस ट्रू इफ परफेक्टली अब्सॉर्बिंग है R is equal to 0 हो जाएगा और उस केस में I by C होता है राइट तो ये जो केस है इस केस से हम सब जो बाकी दो केसेस थे वो सॉल्व कर सकते थे सो ये सब है तो आज के लिए इतना ही थैंक यू